Hey, what's up everybody? Crap Gamer here with Crap Gamer Reviews, back with another video. Thank you guys for checking it out. Please hit that like and subscribe button because I would appreciate that and it would mean a lot to me and it helps out the channel tremendously. So I did a little bit of digging, obviously on Twitter and things like that, because everybody wants to know what's up with the frame rate and is there parity between the Xbox One and Xbox Scorpio as far as the frames per second and things like that. And so what I found just by looking through is weird. So first of all, Mikey Barra, as you guys know, he said developers are free to choose how they use the power of Project Scorpio for games. We have no requirements limiting frame rate or fidelity, which kind of leaves a little bit of ambiguous opening, because that's not exactly confirming that they would allow a 30 frames per second game versus a 60 in the multiplayer, right? So yeah, you do have that to consider. Then somebody asked, but there is a frames per second parity between Xbox One and Scorpio in multiplayer, which means a 2013 console is holding a 2017 console back, to which Mikey Barra responded, no, there isn't. This is up to the developer to choose for their game what they want to do. So that kind of confirms a difference in what we knew from before, because according to their XFest documents, which came out in, I believe, February, they wanted a consistent frame rate between Xbox One and Xbox Scorpio multiplayer games, with a more liberal, flexible frame rate for the single player games. Phil Spencer also responded to a tweet by Shannon Loftus. Says Shannon says it right in the quote that frame rate is determined by the developer. Same thing Mike said, which is the truth. So again, that could be interpreted a little bit ambiguous too, because yes, developer determines frame rate, but at the same time, are they going to allow frame rates to differ between the various consoles? Because that probably wouldn't be too smart. Some people would probably take exception to that. So I asked Shannon Loftus on Twitter. I said her tweet to that was, I said, it's not clear though. Are you saying it'd be okay for Scorpio versions to be 60 FPS and matched against Xbox One versions at 30 FPS? And she said, developer choice, but as a developer, I would bet no one chooses different frame rates for multiplayer games ever. So that is pretty clear cut, in my opinion, that the developers truly have the ability to do whatever they want as in terms of the frame rate and things like that. Now, with that being said, it's pretty clear that, you know, the Xbox Scorpio version of Destiny is likely to be the 30 frames per second, because that just makes the most sense. You know, just for the fact that they're going to want parity for their own game. If you think about it, the PS4 has the largest install base. They're not going to put the best version on the console to be the one with the least amount of people who own it. It just wouldn't make financial sense. People would probably be pretty ticked off. Nonetheless, Sony, we probably will never know completely whose decision it was to limit the frame rate on the Xbox Scorpio version, but it is unfortunate. And so it doesn't look like that's going to be 60 FPS on the Scorpio, but the good news is there are going to be, you know, games like Battlefront 2, Call of Duty World War 2 that are going to be 60. But then again, just because Scorpio is so powerful doesn't mean that every game is going to be 60 on there. Like Red Dead 2, I would assume that that's going to be 4K 30 on Scorpio, because that's how those Rockstar games go. Like, don't expect complete change from the frames per second on Scorpio versus, because that wouldn't make sense. But I figured you guys would want a little bit of investigation as far as the FPS. So it looks like Microsoft has completely changed their stance on the FPS on Scorpio. Like, they could technically allow for different frames per second, but will they? You know, the head of first party says that's likely to never happen. So, I mean, take it for what it's worth, but we're not going to see games that are 30 multiplayer on Xbox One and then have them matched against those running at 60 FPS. And it just kind of wouldn't make sense. This is a hot button topic though, so let me know what you guys think in the comments, or hit me up on Twitter at @_CrapGamer or Xbox Live MOH @SpaceCrapGamer. And as always, we'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Crap Gamer out.